What is good, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another One Chunk at a Time Iron Man number 35. Yes, this time it actually is number 35, not like I said 35 last episode. As you can tell from the title, in this episode we do some pretty cool stuff, and as always, if you guys do see anything that I do miss, put it in the comments and I will get it fixed right away. Before we get into the video, make sure that you hit the like button for the insane stuff that we've achieved on this account. Let's get this episode up to 2,000 likes. I think that sounds good. I do apologize for how inconsistent the uploads have been, but I have enough footage right now where I can probably have about 5 videos out in the next 4 weeks, including this one. So a lot is going to be coming your way, and I'm super excited for it. As always, subscribe if you have not already, like the video, follow the Twitch, join the clan chat. We also have a clan as well. Feel free to join the clan too. Hit us up in the clan chat if you want that. Also follow, go join the Discord too. I haven't shouted that out in like 20 episodes, so join the Discord if you would like to as well. Before we get into the episode, we are going to do a very light recap, so if you are up to date, skip to this timestamp right here and begin the content. If not, this is what we have left to do in this chunk. Also, beware, very, very, very heavy spoilers. Obviously, many moons ago, we did roll the arty chunk, which means we could do the Abyssal mini quest, and we had to finish Sire, which means we had to get a bludgeon, an Abyssal dagger, and an Abyssal head. We ended up getting the Abyssal Held elsewhere, but we did end up finishing the Abyssal Dagger and Bludgeon at Abyssal Sire. Also, with having access to the Abyss, we can get our hands on a giant pouch, and to process that giant pouch, we do need 75 runecrafting. Now, I'm assuming a lot of you guys are going to be wondering why I'm runecrafting what I'm runecrafting in this episode. We did Chaos Runes rather than you might think we'd go and do Nature Runes. I did Chaos Runes because at some point I'm going to need a buttload of Onyxes, so I might as well runecraft a million Chaos Runes while we have that available to us and get that done. Secondly, what we also need to do in this episode is we need to process the jar of sand that we happened to get from Calphite Queen. It was really like a 50-50 split when I put out the poll saying, should I process the jar? And honestly, when it comes down to me, I want to do the integrity move, and also I feel like I need to pay a penance for not having finished Calphite Queen properly the first time. So we are going to go ahead and process that jar of sand. There's a couple other small things along the way, 85 agility, tribal totem, but without further ado, I love you guys. Enjoy the video, like the video, subscribe if you're new, follow the Twitch, join the Discord, it's in the description. I love you all, and I will be back with many, many, many more videos in the upcoming weeks. Also, I do want to answer this question really quickly. I've been asked about a million times how I'm going to be handling combat achievement diaries. And on basically any other account that has ever existed, combat achievement diaries are, you know, they're fun, they're useful, but on Chunkman, unless you start at Wintertod, combat achievement diaries are basically a nothing for you, because Wintertod is likely going to be the last or the second to last thing that you will ever unlock on a chunk account, simply because of how far away it is from your start. So for me, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do all of the easies that I can do and then just do some along the way. There's like literally no point to me doing combat achievement diaries. Unfortunately, I wish they segmented them out further, but obviously, you know, I can't be catered to because I play with my own restrictions. So I have been doing some of the more medium and hard ones as well, but there's no point in us grinding out really any of them at all, to be honest, because I will not be able to do any of the achievement diaries, complete any of them, until basically I complete the chunk map. What a wonderful way to start the newest video. There is 66 runecrafting on the account. So before I ended last video, I pretty much got all the way up to 65. And then just didn't say that I got those levels because I don't know why I didn't say that I got those levels before I ended last video. Well, there's the first level after finishing last video. So there we go. There is 66 runecrafting. It's about as boring as you could probably imagine. Imagine doing Abyssal runecrafting, then you'll know how I feel. So there's not really much to it. And I don't really know what I'm going to be recording this episode, because I've this very long grind with maybe a level shout out here and there. Nice. You know what? I'm not gonna lie. This is actually a pretty cool moment on the account. There is 70 runecrafting. pretty darn cool. But also at the same time, now that we have 70 runecrafting, we are also base 70 for all of our stats as well on the account, which is probably pretty crazy. Obviously, we have 70 runecrafting, hunter, farming, and I believe the last one is fire making. Oh, prayer too. We only have five. Other than those, we're like base 80 or 90. It's pretty crazy. Well, it's me, your boy, back again with another update on the runecrafting grind. It must be nice sitting back and watching about 60 hours of painful progress in about 5 minutes. Man, those were the good old days. But with this right here, this will be 73. Omega lol, kek w, lol w. Wow, 73 is so funny. It's the RuneScape number. It's not the reason why I'm showing you this clip. By me getting that level, that brings us up to 1997 total. Believe it or not, that is the highest total level that I have ever had playing OSRS. I know, it might be kind of crazy to think about. I think Slay Brother got up to 1965 versus 1964, and then Not Slay Brother got up to 1996. So there we go, 1997 on the one chunk at a time account. Imagine that. We continue on, a couple levels left to go. Also, some of you guys will probably say, can't you just 2+ boost using Oldak to process the giant pouch? I asked Mod Ash that a while ago, and he said no. I actually want to test it myself, so we'll go test this just to make sure. Okay, there we go. There is the 5+ boost, and you need to level 75 runecrafting. I have level 75 runecrafting. Mod Ash never lies. Well, with this inventory, I will be getting, one, a very cool milestone on the account, and two, we are going to talk about a very, very brief change of plans as well. This inventory will put us officially above the 100,000 Chaos Runes mark. That is so, so stupid. I hate that I've done this. So from now until the end of this runecrafting level, which is 17K, to get up to 74, which is when we get double chaos. I think I'm just going to do some nature runes just so I can have some stocked for the future. I would never need 100,000 nature runes in the future, but I'm assuming I could use a couple thousand. So we'll make a little bit under 2,000 nature runes until we get up to 74, then we'll switch back to chaos. Man, we are almost done. This is soul-crushing, honestly. Well, it was fun to runecraft something other than Chaos Runes for a couple hours. Can't even see my screen right now. There we go. Thanks, Colby. But there is 74 runecrafting on the account, which means we can now make 2x the Chaos Runes pure essence. Pure essence. Jeez, come on, lock it in, CJ. There we go. There's 74. Now we are back to the chaos, and we only have 13.5k left, which will now equate to 27,000, so we will end at roughly 127,000 chaos runes. Pretty cool. Well, I knew this was a risk the entire time I was runecrafting, but I just got PK'd. Literally 95% of the way through this runecrafting grind, got PK'd for the first time. Unfortunately, I have been running with my rune pouch on me, so I just lost my rune pouch. So at some point, I'm going to have to go and get that back. And that's going to be super obnoxious because I'm going to have to do LMS to get that back and get 75 points. So that is going to take me forever to do. So, yeah, I guess there's the first death. Hopefully my graceful is still there. I'm assuming it is, but that is really obnoxious. Well, my goodness, man. This has been quite the journey. It took me, I'm gonna assume somewhere around 200 hours to obtain everything that I needed to finish the runecrafting, from obtaining all the pure essence to crafting all the pure essence and everything in between. We are finally at our end of the runecrafting grind. But to make it more epic, you may have noticed that I am very, 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 very close to 2,000 total. Well, luckily for you, I caught this in time, and we're going to go ahead and make a super attack potion real quickly. That is going to bring us up to 78 Herblore right there. I can now max Zami Brews, not very useful to me. But most importantly, there it is. It's done. It's finally over. It's finished. Oh my gosh, dude. F this grind, man. There's 75 runecrafting on the one chunk at a time account. Very few to ever have this. And again, Like the jar, this is a pretty fringe grind that I could have just said processing it has absolutely no XP or anything like that. But I did this to not cheapen the series. So there you go. There is 75 runecrafting on the One Chunk at a Time account. Let's go process. Let's go process that giant pouch now. All right, here's my giant pouch. Here's some pure essence. And it goes into the pouch. Oh, there we go. 12 pure essence in the pouch. It's beautiful. It's beautiful, man. It's beautiful. All right, well, that's over. That was your payoff right there. I filled a pouch, so I hope that was worth it. Last night I was AFK woodcutting, and I told myself, CJ, you're going to hop off mobile because you're about to get a level, and you're going to want to record that. You don't want to be on mobile while you do it. So then I got off, and then I got on today and completely forgot that I had this level upcoming. Thank you, Windows, for that. But there is 89 woodcutting on the One Chunk at a Time account, the only woodcutting level that we will get. Unfortunately, we will be very, very, very close to another level. We're not going to get it. Let me check and see how many logs we have in the bank at this point. Our count is up to, I thought it was going to be higher than that, about 6,900 logs. You love to see it. I need about 9,000 more because we need like 17.5k in total, but we do have some steel bars in the bank, like I said, that we're going to use towards the construction grind. So woodcutting is not fun at all. Finally, we are at the end of our road of chopping the oak logs, at least. We still have a good amount left to go, but there we go. There is the last inventory of oaks that we will need, and we are up to 17,000. We would need about 18,000, as I mentioned, but we luckily have a lot of steel bars that should be right there, but are not there. There they are, 2,500 steel bars that we'll use as well. So I guess now begins the time of running back and forth a lot of times to process these. So typically during this portion of making all of these planks, I have absolutely nothing to record, but I've actually kind of discovered, maybe not discovered, maybe it's been known for a while, but a different route that I can run that is about 100 times more efficient than the one that I'm running right now. So typically before, my route was teleport to Varrock, go to the bank, you know, take the planks out of the bank and repeat. But I have actually discovered a new method that I'm going to show you shortly that should significantly decrease the amount of time that we are that we're running around and wasting. That run right there took me 52 seconds to do. Let me show you my other run now. So what this new method is with the dig site pendant. So most of you guys know that the dig site pendant is used to get over to Fossil Island right there. But you can also teleport over here, and it is a very nice shortcut over to the sawmill. Now, unfortunately, I don't really have a great teleport method quickly to a bank. Like Ferox Enclave, it uses the dueling ring, so that would go pretty quickly, and I obviously don't have access to the Castle Wars bank, so I'm using the strength cape for unlimited teleports over here. Now, with this method, this shaves down my previous method by about 20 seconds or so. I think a normal run here takes about 30 to 34 seconds, somewhere in there, depending how hard I'm sweating. So a significantly better increase, and I might be able to like double the time or have the time that it would take me to finish this. So pretty neat thing that I figured I'd show real quickly. So I guess this is kind of like out of the blue and awkward timing because we've been doing not anything related to this for a long time. But I know that I'm going to have more than enough money to finish this construction grind. So I'm going to do something that I probably should have done a long time ago. I am going to insure my giant squirrel. Yes, there you go. My squirrel's insured now. We're happy. That's it. Back to construction. I'm almost done making the planks, too. Well, thank goodness I had the idea to run planks this way, because last time when I ran these planks, it was extremely painful and boring, and it took me like 3 days to do. I know that I had less planks to run this time, but it was a pretty painless process, to be honest. I'm really happy with this new process that I discovered, or maybe, I don't even know if I discovered it, but, you know, the one that I figured out on my own. But there we go. There are the last planks that we do need to make for this construction grind. Let's go take a look at how many we have in the bank. I think we have more than the amount of logs that we chopped for some reason. Okay, so we are up to, well, 17,100 planks. I guess I will be using less steel bars than I anticipated, which is totally fine by me. I'll keep those for Mahogany Homes when that day rolls around. But there we go. All the planks are made, and I guess all we have left to do is go get carpal tunnel.
We are finally at the end of our road with construction. Well, kind of, sort of. These will be the last larders that I'm making right now. We won't be hitting 85 at the moment, but this will put us at 740 XP until 85. I'm going to save the rest of them to do on stream. So there we go. I mean, basically, 85... construction is done. My mental health is at an all-time low, but my player-owned house cosmetics are about to be at an all-time high. I guess I really only have some small things to do from here. We have to catch up on a couple of the easy achievement tasks like we talked about at the beginning of the episode. We need to do tribal totem, and lastly, we need to get that agility level. Ooh, very cool. There is our third mossy key, the last key that we will need to finish. Okay, Colby is holding something down and making me spin around. Show yourself so that they know I'm not cheating. There you go. That is the last key that we will probably need for the easy achievement diaries. Now we have to go get a couple of... I think we only really are going to need two for the Obor part, which will be really easy. Well, since I finished up the Bryophyta keys, I decided to come back to my own personal hell, Hill Giants, and there is the second giant key that I need to finish up the easy diaries. Well, easy achievement diaries. Nope. Easy combat diaries. There we go. I only think I have two Obors that I need to kill. I could do it with one key, but I'm going to do it with two keys just for the memes. Man, I remember back in the day when I used to have to struggle at Bryophyta. Getting one kill was difficult enough, but if we can actually hit here... There we go. There is the last easy Bryophyta task that we need to complete. Oh my gosh, didn't even get a Bryophyta essence. I did get three keys for this, as I said, and I only used two to finish all of them. So I think I'm just going to go use this key on a real world. This was the free-to-play world, by the way. So I think I'll just go get another kill. If I get a Bryophyta's essence, I'll let you know, but I probably won't.
Goodness, after a few hours of doing agility, man, agility is so boring. We are going to be crossing under the 20k mark, which is the mark that I wanted to get to before we started tomorrow's stream. Now, we only have one thing left to do before we can, you know, pretty much be fully prepared to roll our chunk tomorrow.
So I was planning on making like a cool little quirky transition clip where I was like, and the last item we need, and then I would start this clip was saying mahogany logs, but absolutely F this grind so hard. So allegedly, according to the wiki, these dudes drop mahogany logs at a rate of 1 in 64. I am fairly certain that is not the case. I just killed 700 tortoises, 700, and got 3 2 drops. I got 6 mahogany logs in 700 kills from a 1 in 64. Luckily, I'm thanking my lucky stars right now. We have some mahogany logs from who knows when. I don't know when I got these. Must have been when I went for a teak log grind in the past. Luckily, we have those mahogany logs, but those guys are not 1 in 64, and if they are, I just went stupidly unlucky. But there we go. There's the last thing that we need, and now we can just go, I don't know, finish this chunk. Well, we will be finishing up the last obstacle that we need to do for 85 agility. Man, that's beautiful to see. Such a clean number as well. We can now 5+ boost to do a lap on the Arty rooftops. That is wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I'm very happy to see that. Now we only have a couple more things left to do, then we get to roll a chunk. Let's go! Yes, you love getting back-to-back 85 levels on an account, but there is 85 construction added to the one chunk at a time as well. So there we go. I can't really build anything cool. Maybe all the volcanic theme. No, dude, the volcanic theme. I can now build a fancy rejuvenation pool fairy ring. That's pretty cool. Most importantly, we can 2+ boost to make a bossing lair. So we're going to do that real quickly. And then process big air quotation marks on that one, process a jar of sand. All right, let's go ahead and throw away 200K GP. Yes, that is my real cash stack at the moment, if you were wondering. I actually do only have 80K GP left. Now we need to work on getting our boost real quickly. Then we can 2 plus boost and process our jar. All right, time to process the jar storage, because that's basically what it is. Let's build our boss lair. Wonderful, let's go. There it is. There is the boss storage lair done, and we can toss in our jar of sand. And ooh, that's pretty. That is pretty. So there we go. You know, as I mentioned, the jar of sand, processing it in the player owned house, kind of a fringe thing, but at the end of the day, one, I felt it to be the more integral move to do it, and two, I guess it's kind of my penance for not completing Calfight Queen when I first got it. So there we go. There is Calfight Queen complete. We only have a couple more things left to do. The second to last thing that we need to complete on this journey is completing the rest of the easy achievement combat diaries. The only thing we have left to do... Oh, wait, no. I have to kill a greater demon and a fire giant, don't I? Okay, well, I'll do that after, but I'm not going to show it. I need to kill Obor while he's immobilized and while on a free-to-play world. I'm going to do both of those, hopefully in one swing, because I only have... one key. I know I showed that I did get two keys in a clip, and I finished all of the Obor tasks in one key. So we're going to try to complete them on the easies as well now, too. Yeah, I can snare. I think I can get another good hit in here. Maybe two if it's a low hit next. Ooh. Let me see if I can get him down a little bit more HP with like a punch or something. Okay, that should be good. No! Auto retail was on! No! Darn near 200 kills later out here, we finally get another key. So that was a very costly mistake. We went from a 60 kill count starting here to 240 kill count at the Giants. And it's a 1 in 64 drop rate. So I'm just not having a good time with 1 in 64 drop rates right now. All right, let's go in with take number two. You know, what could possibly go wrong this time? All right, this should be it. Yes, there we go. Kill Obor while he's immobilized, the sleeping giant. No, oh my gosh, no club on that kill. Unreal. Well, there is 234 Obor kill count. Probably will be the last Obor that we ever kill on this account. Probably. Well, this was actually probably the hardest quest I've ever done in my entire life, but oh my gosh, there is tribal totem complete. Let's go, dude. 5 swordfish and 1800 thieving XP. That's insane, dude. Now we only have one thing left to do before we can roll a new chunk, ladies and gentlemen. This is the last step that we need to take to finish what most called the impossible chunk. The series ender will be finished as soon as I click this green box. Hundreds of hours developing an entirely new meta, doing some terrible things to get here. We finished Abyssal Sire. We got 75 runecrafting. We processed a jar of sand. And the hardest of all, we did tribal totem as well. But it is time to finish that part of our journey and begin a new one. Hopefully a journey of freedom and of fun adventures in the future, because a lot of the terrible things on the board have been taken off. And honestly, I think that we are looking forward to a very, very fun time in our chunk future. So with that being said, let us take our last steps in this chunk before we are finished. And there it is. There is the arty chunk complete. Done. It is over. It is finished. Probably about 450 hours spent in this chunk over the past 43 days. And gosh dang, I am ready to roll a new chunk, and my goodness, I am excited. Since it has been 45 days since we've rolled a chunk, we are going to do a chunk review as well, but we're not going to do a full one. I'm only going to go over the important stuff, so let's get right into it. 22 would be Laren's chest. I have a couple of keys, which would be actually, I think this Laren's chest would be pretty cool. 11 wouldn't unlock anything. These basically wouldn't unlock anything. 23 would be KBD. Don't really need anything from KBD. I'll have to go back and get the head at some point, but I can't process it at this point. 25 would be Chaos Altar. It would be really nice for prayer XP. 24 would be top of the list for chunk rolls. That would be Wilderness God Wars Dungeon. I could get Prims and Ecumenical Keys. 13 and 14, probably the most dangerous rolls on the board right now. Callisto and Venonatus right there. 3 and 1 would be amazing. That would be a new farm, and then I would get closer to being able to do whatever the Undead Chicken quest is. It's forgetting me at the moment. 1 would be allow me to start the Recipe for Disaster, so I'd be thrilled about that. These 3 are basically nothing. This would get us closer to Morton, and we'd be able to do a couple of quests, so I'd be happy to unlock that. 7 would be nothing because I can go there. 8 would unlock a Teak Tree. I'd be happy to do that. It'd get me one step closer to getting Stew Boost. Basically, nothing else is unlocked in the desert as well. That would be closer to Temperos. That would start the Flippers and Hat grind. Falador would unlock a massive amount, and we'll go over that if we unlock it. 28, 31, nothing. 30, get us very close to God Wars, which I'd be thrilled to get. 35, basically nothing. 32, I'd be super happy to get that. I'd be much closer to getting like Heroes Quest and stuff like that undone. 33 would be cool. 34, 37, nothing. 44 and 45, I think they both unlock quests. 48 would be Nightmare Zone and a couple of cool unlocks. 53 would be wonderful because that would be Underground Pass. I'd be very happy to get that. Not much around here as well. 55 would be amazing for that Castle Wars bank. 59, I'd be happy to get. That would unlock the Soul Wars for us, and basically nothing else around here. And then left on Zaya, not a whole bunch. Like I said, I don't really know what's unlocked on Zaya. We'll tackle that when we get there, because I just don't know what's unlocked here. The only thing that I know is Seracnus is unlocked here, which I would be very, very, very happy to unlock, and Skatizo as well. So, without further ado, I think we touched on everything I wanted to. Oh, except down here, if I roll 46, that'd be the full pest control. I couldn't get elite right now, but we'll get there when we can. So, without further ado, let's roll a new chunk. Honestly, not a whole lot terrible on the board right now. Let's see where we go, though. 3, 2, 1. Let's do this thing. Ooh. We have all of Hosidius unlocked now. Let me go check this out. I do not know if this starts anything immediately. Okay, let me go double check this. This is a really good unlock. Well, this is a beautiful area, but there's just nothing to unlock here. So I guess we're off to another chunk roll. The only thing that's really been unlocked with unlocking that chunk for right now is if we unlock 69, we can then plow. Yep, you heard me. 69 unlocks plows. All right, let's do another chunk roll. 3, 2, 1, go. What did I unlock? The pyramid. Oh no, dude. The quarry is right there. That unlocks a terrible grind. Just a lot of money grind. But yeah, I mean, we all know the ancient pyramid. We're not gonna go take a visit. There's nothing to see there. Let us roll a new chunk. Let's do this thing and go. Ooh, and Trana unlocked. Again, I don't think anything is there. Enlightened Journey. I can't do Enlightened Journey. I do not have Enlightened Journey doable. I'll check. Here. Quest progression, Enlightened Journey. I have Enlightened Journey doable. Okay, I guess I can do Enlightened Journey. Just kidding. Upon further investigation, I can allegedly do Enlightened Journey, so it is a good thing that I did not roll there, because I would have looked like a goofball. Well, it is a very good thing that I double-checked that I could do Enlightened Journey. There we go. Enlightened Journey is done. One quest point, a handful of XP, which is wonderful to see. Balloon transport access, not super useful quite yet. I think at some point it might be useful, but for right now, it is not that useful. Anyway, we don't really have much left to do in our current chunk, and by not much, I mean nothing. So, let us roll another chunk. We finished Enlightened Journey, and then the other thing that we did have to do, we had to unlock the Varrock route for the balloon course, and all the other unlockable ones are already unlocked. So, without further ado, let us roll another chunk. Let's do this thing. 3, 2, 1, go! Ooh. Okay, that's Wolf Ball or whatever it's called. I think I'll have to do a lap there. But other than that, I don't think that there's anything doable other than the Werewolf Agility Dungeon. So we're going to have to go get 1KC there. All right, so as I figured, we cannot get down here without the Ring of Chaos from the Creature of Frankenstrain. And I believe we only need this chunk here to unlock that. And this is super minor anyway. It would take me 3 minutes to do either one, so it's not a big deal, honestly. All right, we move on. We roll another chunk. All right, let's do this thing. What is our next chunk going to be? Will we unlock anything significant? Let's find out. 3, 2, 1, go. Ooh. Basically nothing. Item spawns? Yeah, nothing. All right, we're going to roll a new chunk. My CBA going to visit there. We already know what that looks like. Let us roll another chunk. 3, 2, 1. Next chunk is... Wow. Literally the opposite side there. Again, actually doesn't matter. I mean, it's fun to to get them back to back, but literally both nothing chunks. All right. Another one. Let's do this. 3, 2, and let's go. Ooh. ZMI. Okay, we're actually going to go take a peek at this one. This would have been useful a while ago while I was on my 75 runecrafting grind. It's no longer useful. We basically only have to do one run here, but I'm happy to do it. That's a pretty good chunk to unlock. Okay, let's go take a peek there. All right, so we went ahead and caught a red salamander, got that out of the way, and now we are going to do a little bit of runecrafting at the Orina Altar. Our first ever astral runes on the account, pretty cool. I didn't even know that you could make astral runes here. And there we go. There's a full inventory done here. That's basically all I have to do here. So I'm going to leave and go do something else now, I guess. Yeah. All right, let's do this thing. Man, it's nice being able to go in different chunks. Roll. Wait, oh, I didn't click on it. Yes, let's go! Underground Past. Yes, that is the chunk that I've been waiting on for so long. Yes, the Underground Pass chunk has been unlocked, and we can do the Underground Pass quest. That is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful to see. I am very, very, very happy to have that. We can go do Underground Pass now and get an Ibon Staff, imbue that bad boy, and I don't know, enjoy life, man. That's a great unlock right there. Oh man, that is a great unlock that I'm happy to get.
Hello, it is me from the editing floor. Well, I obviously at some point completed Underground Pass. When I went to go pull the footage, it was just completely corrupt and I didn't realize until, well, right now. So I completed Underground Pass. It is my favorite quest in the entire game and I did my best to speedrun it as well. I did it once over on the guide and got 27 minutes and 27 seconds on the quest. Allegedly, the world record's about 24 minutes and 30 seconds and I was like 2 minutes short after only doing a once over on the guide. So I think, I mean, honestly, I'd kind of be down to do a speedrun and break the world record at some point on the Underground Pass because I freaking love that quest. Anyway, get back to the normal stuff.
Now all we have left to do is to upgrade our Ibon Staff at the dude and then turn in a cat as well, and then we'll be done. All right, Mr. Civilian, take... Wait, what? No, do you want my cat? Yeah, I have a cat. You can take it. Take my cat. He's good at killing stuff. See ya later, Colby. I'll see ya. Oh, wait, what? Why didn't you take... Wait, what? See ya later, Colby. It was nice knowing ya. I'll see you in the next life.
All right, and here we go. Can you upgrade my Ivan staff? There you go.
Can hold 250 charges, 200k GP. I'm down. Take my money. Nice. Okay. Well, there's the rest of that chunk complete. And now, technically, we can begin to roll the elven chunks, which is pretty wild, actually.
All right. So, now that we have this chunk done, which is such a good chunk to have, I'm so happy to have the Ivan staff, we can, believe it or not, begin to roll into the elven lands. We have 70 rollable. We will have to go through the entirety of the underground pass if we want to get there, but that is rollable now. So, nothing really new other than that, as far as I'm aware. If you see anything, definitely let me know in the comments, but we can roll a new chunk. And here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Why do I keep unlocking over here? This is just a bunch of nonsense. I don't want to unlock over here anymore. Give me 52 or 53 if you're going to lock over there. Not those crap chunks. Okay. And another one. What did I just roll? Ooh, Port Cazard. Okay. So that's actually really good. We can do fishing trawler now, ? And we can get the full fishing trawler outfit. Let's go, fishing trawler. Wow. I'm so happy. Fishing trawler, guys. This is going to be so much fun. This is the content that we've all been waiting for. Fishing trawler. Okay, dude.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, and that is going to do it for this episode of the One Chunk at a Time Iron Man. Yes, I know, I left you on that insane cliffhanger, dude. Will we ever get the fishing trawler outfit? I don't know. You'll have to wait till next week to find out. It's pretty crazy, but I love you guys. I hope you guys all did enjoy. I will be back next week with another upload of One Chunk at a Time. So I guess I'll see you guys. Like the video if you have not already. Subscribe if you're new, and I will see you in some live streams. If you want to be there, massive spoilers, just a warning, but I'll see you guys. Take it easy. Take care of yourself.